Call me Cuban Pete. I'm the king of the rumba beat. When I play the maracas, I go chick chicky boom, chick chicky boom.
Hey, vinyl community, it's LJ. I was doing a little crate digging today, and I came across three oddities, three test pressings, and these test pressings weren't labeled. Not so much. So, first of all, I mean, folks in the vinyl community, you know what a test pressing is, right? But for perhaps anyone that doesn't, or even anyone in the vinyl community that isn't familiar, this is a test pressing. Now, a test pressing, let's go straight from the label. This is a test pressing intended for use in determining the technical quality of the recording only. It's not intended for sale or distribution outside of this company. So for folks that have followed a record from the route to recording all the way up until it's released for commercial purposes or consumer purchase, a test pressing is when it's first being put onto vinyl. And do the engineers need to adjust the mix, adjust the sound, adjust the press, and so forth? Now, these test pressings, again, turned up, and let me show you what they said. They're in standard white sleeves. This one says 1033A, too much static. That doesn't tell me too much about it. So I was kind of looking for anything I could find, deadwax, so forth. All I could find in the deadwax was my only clue, in that it said ECM. Didn't want to jump to too many conclusions. This one didn't say anything. So we have absolutely no information there. But we have some handwriting here. And again, this is a secondhand vinyl market, so that could be or mean anything. We have, again, the same dead wax information. It's etched completely differently. But same thing, test pressing, 1975, Columbia Records, Pittman, New Jersey. No information other than the handwritten, what looks to be the same or matching, and I couldn't really see the dead wax too well at the time when I picked them up. Information, ECM 1067, 68A and B, 1218-75. Now stop. Everybody that's bouncing off to Wikipedia or Google right now, I've definitely already done it. So seeing ECM in the dead wax told me immediately it's jazz on ECM. Seeing this here, the dead wax numbers, and that it matches, of course, now I know this is the correct polyline inner sleeve. But here we also have the date, and this was cool. So 12/18/75. Now bear in mind, at that point, I'm still deciding whether or not to pick them up and have a little fun with them. Test pressings are cool. They're a neat little slice of history. Can you grab that? Mm-hmm. And here we have A and B, not warped, surface normal. And the same thing on this one. Again, polylined inner sleeve with no writing on it, just the vinyl itself. So I did decide to grab these, take these home, and kind of have some fun with them with you guys here on YouTube. About all I've done at this point is, and was it this one? No, this one has dead wax information, is I did show these to Renee and said, okay, it's ECM, it's got to be jazz. So let's go ahead and look up the numbers online. Looking up the numbers online, who is it, who could it be? Here's what we came up with, or the artist, if you haven't already bounced off to Google this, what this album tracks back to be. Now, bear in mind, we haven't listened to this yet. It could be, it could not be, who knows? The needle has not hit the vinyl, maybe since 1975. Who knows? That would be older than me.
Yeah.
That would be older than you, because you're younger than me.
Yes, I am. A lot younger.
Not a lot younger. No. She's a year younger than me. So let's go ahead and drop it. But before we do that, here's a picture of what came up online when looking up these particular matrix numbers or ECM numbers. So you can see the picture right now. I've never heard of this artist. It appears to be a Norwegian guitarist. And this was, if that's in fact what this is, this album was recorded in Norway in August 1975. What did the information on that one say? December 1975 is when the test pressings were being reviewed, but they were pressed in Pittman, New Jersey. Okay, so maybe it was recorded in Norway, mastered in the U.S. Not at all unheard of. But let's end the mystery. Let's drop the needle on these, see what they sound like, see if it is in fact that release. And no, I'm not even going to try to say his name. Forget it. Here we go. That sounded familiar to anybody, but that was the first needle drop. It was definitely ECM-ish sounding, and it's starting to look like Stars and Moon are going to align here, and that is in fact from that artist, being a Norwegian guitarist. The Deadwax is lining up, the notes are lining up, but let's go ahead and needle drop one more track just to see, you know, does this recording have a pulse? And I mean, I don't know, I've never even heard of this artist, and that's the cool thing about digging. You just never know what you're going to stumble across. Drops, I'm gonna go ahead and draw the conclusion that it probably is in fact that artist. Here's the picture again that you saw earlier. Again, I'm not familiar with it, so I'm gonna have to see if I can find some sound clips. I have no clue if this record or if this CD is readily available. I'm guessing it's probably not. I could be wrong. It does happen every now and then.
No.
I wish I could see over my shoulder right now. But so that's it. Here's the That's the three mystery ECM test pressings that showed up today. Like I said, I haven't listened to any of the other ones yet. This one says too much static. I guess maybe in the ears of an engineer or a producer for commercial release, maybe so. And this one as well, which has no information on it, but it does have the same Deadwax numbers, right? So I'm not even going to go ahead and play that one. ECM 106768. So these are all the same record, and that's it. I do have to say it was cool, and it was fun to kind of find out what they were and just share them all with you. Harry Bottom community, hope you guys had fun with it. Feel free to leave a comment if you have one. You know, it's definitely always cool to hear from you guys, anybody familiar with that release. Talk to you guys soon. Take care.
Bye.
Ciao.